Good morning, students, and welcome to today's maths class. So in the last classes we had started with the chapter geometry, right? So in the beginning we saw the few basics of geometry. Then we saw what are parallel lines and perpendicular lines, what are intersecting lines, we saw what are angles and the different types of angles. Then in the last class we studied what are triangles and what are the different types of triangles based on length of the sides and the angles in a triangle. Alright, so in today's class we'll learn what are circles. So before moving on to circles, we will see what are the what we did in the last class first, a quick recap, and then we'll move on to the next topic. So what's a triangle? A triangle is a closed figure consisting of three line segments which are linked end to end, correct? So this is how a triangle looks like. Then types of triangles based on the length of the sides. So we have scalene triangle, we have isosceles triangle and equilateral triangle. What is a scalene triangle? Triangles in which none of the sides are of the same length are called as scalene triangle. Then isosceles triangle are triangles in which two of the sides are of the same length, okay? Two sides have equal length. Then equilateral triangles are triangles in which all the sides are of the same length. Okay, so scalene triangle, where none of the sides are of the same length. Isosceles triangle, where two of the sides are of the same length. Then equilateral triangle, in which all of the sides are of the same length. So in the previous class, I also told you in an equilateral triangle, all the three angles are also equal to 60 degrees. All three angles are equal and they are equal to 60 degrees. In an isosceles triangle, you have two angles which are equal, and in a scalene triangle, all the three angles are different. Okay, then here types of triangles based on measurement of angles. So you have acute angle, you have obtuse angle, and you have right angle. What's an acute angle? The angles in which all the three angles measure less than 90 degrees. So when all the three angles measure less than 90 degree in a triangle, it is called as an acute angle triangle. Then obtuse angle triangle, when the triangles in which angles one angle measures greater than 90 degree and less than 180. So the triangle in which one angle is greater than 90 degree is called as an obtuse angle triangle. Then right angle. What is a right angle? Where one angle is equal to 90 degree. Okay, where one angle measures exactly 90 degree. Okay, so acute angle, where all our angles are less than 90 degrees. So if you look at this figure, you have 80, 30 and 70 as the three angles in a triangle. Then obtuse angle, where one angle measures greater than 90. So here you have one angle 110, the other two are 30 and 40. Okay. Then right angle triangle, where one angle measures exactly 90 degree. So here angle B is 90 degree. Okay. So this is how a right angle triangle looks like. Then some other properties of a triangle. So all the angles in the scalene triangle are different. Two angles in the isosceles triangle are equal. Then all the angles in an equilateral triangle are equal and they are equal to 60 degrees. And all the angles in any triangle add up to 180 degrees. So this is what we studied about triangles, and we saw a few questions on this, right? Today we will study what are circles. So let's move on to circles now. Okay, so we will start with what a circle, and we are going to learn the different parts of a circle. So circle and its parts. Okay, so where do you see circles in your daily life? So your cycle wheels are circular in shape. Then the Ashoka Chakra on the flag is a circle. Okay, then here if you see wind chimes, then this is a circle here. Then CD is a circle. Your coins are in circular shapes. Okay, and this is also a circle. So many musical instruments are also have circular surface. So this is a drum which is circle, then tabla, okay, and these are different kinds of drums which are circular in shape. Okay, and you see circles in sports also. So your basketball hoops are circles, right? So the Olympics logo that is there, those are also circles here, correct? Then, what is a circle? You all see circles so many times in your daily life. What is a circle? A circle is a closed curve in a plane. It is a closed plane figure, okay, with a curved surface. So a circular can be drawn with the help of any circular object. So here they've told, for example, a circle can be drawn with the help of a coin. Okay, so this is how a circle looked like. Okay, now first part of a circle is a center. Okay, so a circle is a closed curve consisting of all points in a plane which are at a same distance from a fixed point. Now here if you see, how many of the points you draw on this circle, okay, they'll be at a fixed or at the same distance from a fixed point inside it. Okay, so there'll be a fixed point inside the circle, okay, which will be at the same distance from the circumference of the circle. Okay, so this point is called as the center. Okay, this fixed point inside a circle is called as the center of a circle. So a circle has only one center. Okay, a circle has one and only one center. So this is a center. Then radius. What is a radius? Radius is a line segment that joins any point of on the circle to its center. Okay, so this is a radius. When you join the center and any point on the circle, then that line segment is called as a radius. So your OM is a radius. All right. And then, so radii means it's a plural of radius. Radii of a circle are equal in length. So as you know, this is the center of a circle, right? From this, you can draw many line segments to different points on a circle. So all these line segments will have equal length. Okay, all of them will have equal length, and there are infinite number of radius in a circle. So infinite number of radius can be drawn in a circle. All right. Then diameter. What is diameter? It is a line segment that joins any two points on the circle and it passes through the center. Okay, it is a line segment which joins two points on a circle. So if here if you see this line segment AB is joining the points A and B on the circle, okay, and it is passing through the center. It is necessary that the line segment passes through the center, then only it is called as a diameter. If the line segment is over here, okay, joining two points on the circle, but it is not passing through the center, so this will not be a diameter. This has a different term which we will see next, but the diameter should pass through the center. Okay, so this is the diameter. Then, okay, so again, there are infinite number of diameters in a circle. So infinite number of diameters can be drawn in a circle. As the radii of a circle are equal in length, its diameters too are equal in length. Okay, radius are also equal in length and diameters also are equal in length. So you will have many diameters in a circle and all will be of the same length. All right. Now you have to remember here a diameter is twice the radius. Okay. So if your radius is 2 centimeters, then your diameter will be 2 times the radius. That is, it will be 4 centimeters. Okay. If your radius is 6 centimeters, diameter will be 2 into 6, 12 centimeters. All right. So length of the diameter is twice the length of the radius. Now, if you see here, radius OM, that is this, plus radius ON gives you the diameter MN. So, length of a diameter of a circle is twice the length of its radius. Okay, then coming to a chord. What is a chord now? Here, A is a point on the circle, B is another point on a circle. So, a line segment joins any two points on a circle is called as a chord. So, a line segment which joins any two points on the circle is called as a chord. Now see here, you have different chords. So you have chord MN, chord KL and chord CD or diameter CD. Now diameter is also a chord of the circle. Okay, diameter is also a chord of the circle. Now here MN and KL, these are not diameters because they don't pass through the center. So I told you alright that a line which does not passes the center but joins any two points on the circle is called as a chord. Okay, it is called as a chord, and the chord which passes through the center of the circle will be a diameter. So if you see here, the diameter is the longest chord. So how many of the chords are there, the diameter will always be the longest chord. Okay, so here they have given you different chords. Now again, you have infinite number of chords can be drawn in a circle. So you have infinite number of radius in a circle, infinite number of diameters can be drawn in a circle, and infinite number of chords also can be drawn in a circle. But radius are all equal in length, diameters are also all equal in length, chords will not be all of the same length, they will be of different lengths. Okay. Okay, next we have something called as an arc. What is an arc? An arc is the distance between any two points on the circumference of a circle. So this is the outer boundary of a circle is called as a circumference. Okay, and the distance between any two points on the circumference of a circle is called as a arc. Now the black colored black part marked on the circle is an arc. Okay. So how do you name it? You name it like this: arc KXL. Okay, an arc is named by three points. Remember, you can't just name it as an arc KL. You need to name an arc by three points. So you name it as arc KXL. Okay, of which two are end points and the third one lies in between them. So K and L here are the end points and X lies in between them. Okay. So now here this KXL is called as a minor arc because it's a smaller one, and the arc KYL is called as a major arc. So an arc divides the circle into two parts. The smaller arc is the minor arc and the larger one is the major arc. So example of an arc is a rainbow. Then semicircle. What is a semicircle? Half of a circle is called as a semicircle. Now a circle is also an arc of the circle. So semicircle is nothing but it is half of a circle. So now if you see here, this is one half of a circle and this is another half of a circle. Okay, so these are two semicircles. So recap of the terms. This is what is the center. Then we saw what is the radius. It is a point which joins the center to any point on the circle. Then a diameter which joins two points on a circle and passes through the center. Then a chord which joins two points on a circle. Then we saw what is an arc. It is two points on a circle on the circumference. Okay, and a semicircle which is half of a circle. Right? So this is all we learnt in this. So this is all about circle and its parts. Okay, so now I'll show you all a video on circle. Okay, so it will show you all the different parts of a circle and also how to construct a circle. Okay, let's see the video now.
Construction. Today, let's revise about circle and its construction. Look at these objects. They are all circular in shape. A circle is a plane figure in which all the points are at a same distance from the center. Now, let's learn some of the important terms related to the circle. Look at the figure. Here, point A is the center of the circle. Center of the circle is the fixed point from which the circle is drawn. Line segment AB is a radius of the circle. Radius is the segment that extends from the center of the circle to any point on the circle. Line segment PQ is a diameter of the circle. Diameter is the segment that joins any two points on the circle and it always passes through the center of the circle. Line segment MN is a chord of the circle. Chord is the segment that joins any two points on the circle. The diameter is the longest chord. The circumference of a circle is the perimeter of the circle. When we fold circle along the diameter, we get two half circles. They are called semicircles. And lastly, half a semicircle forms quarter of a circle. Let's now learn how to draw a circle. To draw a circle, we use a compass. A compass has two arms, a metal arm and a pencil arm, connected by a hinge. Step 1. Keep the metal point of the compass firmly on a fixed point. Step 2. Stretch the arm of the compass that holds the pencil. Step 3. Move the pencil arm around, keeping the metal arm fixed. Hey, look! We have drawn a circle. Now, let's draw one more circle. But this time, with a radius of 4.5 centimeters. Step 1. Use a ruler to set the distance between both the arms as 4.5 centimeters. Step 2. Place the point of the compass on a fixed point. Step 3. Move the pencil arm around to draw the circle. Do you know? 1. The diameter is the longest chord. 2. Diameter is equal to twice the radius. 3. A circle has many radii and diameters. Kids, wasn't it fun learning about the circle? Why don't you try drawing a few on your own?
So in the video you all saw what we just learned about circle and its parts. And we also you'll also saw how to construct a circle, correct? So using the same method, what you have to do here in we'll solve a few questions. So question 1, construct a circle of radius 6 centimeter, mark the following. Okay, so what you have to do here is you need to first measure 6 centimeters using your compass, compass and scale, how they showed in the video, and then you have to draw a circle of 6 centimeters. Okay, I do not have a compass I cannot use a compass on the screen right now. Okay, so I've drawn a circle. We'll assume that it has a radius 6 centimeters. Okay, so now you have to mark the following. So you have to mark a radius OA. So before that, let's mark a center point. Okay, or the center of a circle. So if this is a center O, okay, we'll mark that as center O. Then the radius will be something like this. Okay, so this is the radius OA. So we'll mark this point on the circle as A. So you can write it outside the circle. I don't have place, so I'm writing it here. Okay, so this is the point A. Then chord AB. So from this point only you have to draw a chord AB. So we'll draw a chord here like this. Okay, so this is A and B. Okay, so this is B. So we'll name this point as B. This is chord AB. Then diameter PQ. Okay, you have to draw a diameter PQ. So you know that diameter passes through the center of a circle, right? So we'll draw a line like this. So this is a diameter PQ. So here P, and this you can mark as Q. Alright, then point E on the exterior of the circle. Since it is exterior of the circle, it can be anywhere outside the circle. So we'll mark it over here. So that is point E. Okay, we'll mark it as point E. Now point I on the interior of a circle. So I'll mark the point I over here on anywhere inside the circle. So I'll mark it here. Okay, so that is point I. So that's I. Okay, so this was first question. Now make sure that you draw a circle of radius 6 centimeters. Now question 2. Name the following in the given figure. Center. Now which is the center over here? What have they marked the center as? The center over here is C. Correct? The center is C. So we'll write here C. Now radius. Which is the radius here in this figure? The radius here is CP or CB. So you can write CP or CB as the radius of that particular circle, that chord. Which is the chord that they've shown here? The chord here is chord AB. So AB. Then diameter. So what's the diameter they have to show? The diameter here which passes through the center is PB. Okay, an arc. Which is the arc here? Now if you see, they marked this point D. So arc ADB. Okay, so this was question number 2. Now question 3 is a part of your homework. Okay, so do that for your homework. Complete it. And so this completes the chapter geometry. Okay, in the next class, we'll start with the next topic. Alright, I'll see you all in the next class, students. Thank you.